DeFi, or the decentralized finance, has seen constant increase in numbers in the last few quarters. And even in this year, despite all the highs and lows in sense of cryptocurrency prices, the DeFi numbers have only shown an uptrend. Now, what DeFi is, it is a cryptocurrency and a blockchain-based form of finance. It is exactly the opposite of centralized finance. It does not rely on central financial intermediaries like the banks, NBFC, financial institutions, or brokerages for that matter. What it does is, it uses smart contracts on blockchains. Open source, transparent, permissionless ecosystem is what clearly defines it. The transactions in this case are stored in computer code on a decentralized public ledger, which is available to everybody who's part of that DeFi online and real time. It is built using smart contracts secured on the blockchain, and that's what we also call it as dApps. That is the app that serves the DeFi in various sectors. Apps for various sectors such as real estate, art, and insurance are just a few to name where DeFi or dApps are used at this point in time. dApps also has various functions, and they are known as DeFi. There are various layers on how a DeFi works, and they are divided into four. I'll start with the base layer, which is also called the zero layer. It consists of public blockchain and native digital currency. For the sake of an example, much of the DeFi work right now is done on Ethereum as a blockchain or a platform, and the native token here is Ether. The other one is the protocol layer. Now, the DeFi protocol layer provides liquidity. It is interoperable, and multiple entities can be using it at the same time for their services and apps as well. The next layer is called the application layer. It converts underlying protocol into simple consumer-focused services. What application layer also done is that it combines the two here. And the fourth one then is the aggregation layer. This is where most of the work really happens. It connects applications to provide services. This is where the seamless money transfer between different financial instruments actually happens. This is also an area where lending, borrowing, banking services, crypto wallets, all of that exist on this final layer.